There are about 1.7 million Palestinian citizens of Israel. They are subject to a discriminatory regime that greatly resembles, in key ways, the Jim Crow era in the American South. About 2.5 million or so Palestinians live in the occupied Palestinian territories, including in East Jerusalem. They live in something much worse than a Jim Crow regime. They have no vote. They have no say in the government that rules crucial elements of their lives. It's actually about half of the Palestinians. These are the people that were expelled in 1948 during a Nakba, and throughout all the years since then. One thing that they all have is the right, under all applicable international law, to return to their country. And this is a right that Israel is absolutely adamant about denying. People of conscience all over the world have an obligation to pay attention to abuses of human rights like this, like what's the 71-year regime of dispossession and subjugation, a sort of boycott, divestment, and sanctions movement that 170 Palestinian civil society organizations called for in 2005. So it called for boycotting Israel until it meets some ordinary requirements, some minimal requirements of moral behavior on the part of nations. But joining the boycott, divestment, and sanctions movement is a platform to try to persuade other people of conscience that this is something that is really needs our attention. And there's many totally honorable reasons, and especially for people in the United States, to focus particularly on this issue of great moral impact.